Are you awake? I thought I heard you get up.
Yeah, I'm awake. Sorry, I just can't sleep.
Are you thinking about him?
Yeah, a bit. You should get back to sleep, my love. I'm fine.
No, it's okay. What else is on your mind?
I don't know. It seems weird, but I had one of the most vivid dreams of my life. I saw a fox on a snowy mountain, just looking confused and worried. Those eyes. I can't get those eyes out of my head. She was running in the windy snow, looking for something.
Do you think it has to do with you and what's been going on?
I don't know. It was just a dream, Rachel. They're not meant to make sense. A lot's happened the past couple days, that's all.
Well, if you're not going to sleep anyway, you should tell me. I want to hear.
All right. So, not far from her home, she followed that path to something unexpected. She couldn't stay, though. She had to find her other two children. So she took that path. She followed it towards something ancient. Something with answers. High and low, searching for any sign of her cubs. Points of light showed the way to this ancient tree. It was as if each one had a story to tell, all their own. The land was trying to tell my story, too. I felt like I was right behind her the whole time. Thank you.
Wasn't he like a lumberjack?
That's one way of putting it. If wood was a canvas, then a carving knife was his paintbrush. Even after working a 50-hour week, even after his hands were more splinters than skin, he would bring home the nicest piece of Alaskan weeping cedar and make me toys. That wooden train was the first toy I can remember, and I loved it. I just knew from a young age I was going to be a lumberjack, like my father. My teenage years were full of sketching, angst, and trouble. I wasn't popular or unpopular. Maybe just forgettable. I guess that gave me a sense of freedom. So I hung out with crazy kids, doing crazy things, even though I mostly just watched the chaos ensue. We did it all. Put fireworks in mailboxes, hide roadkill in people's garages, break windows of the barbershop in Anchorage. My dad was furious. But he was so busy working, he couldn't do much to stop me from going out.
I think being an adult means there's no one to stop you making hard decisions. He had to make a living, and he couldn't be in two places at once.
Yeah, I realize that now. But at the time, I was sure he was more interested in growing his business than what was going on with me. He was working another late night, and my friends were over, saying how bored they were and how they had come all the way out to my house for nothing. One of them mentioned how that old, ugly beyond belief truck was still in the garage, and how we should take it for a spin. I was only 15, so I kind of fought it for a while. The next thing I knew, we were careening around the mountain path, rocks spitting onto the side.